Now let's talk about the axilla. Let me first of all orient you. This is the head. Part of the face has been removed. This is the neck. This is the thorax, upper limb. Of course, those areas have been dissected, and you need to get yourself your head rounded before we proceed. The axilla, it is pyramidal in shape. And it has an apex, it has a base, anterior wall, posterior wall, lateral and medial walls, of course. I will demonstrate to you the anterior wall of the axilla. Now my hand now is in the axilla. Okay, so where is the axilla? The axilla between the upper part of the humerus or the arm and the side of the thorax here. So what is anterior to my hand or my fingers is the anterior wall of the axilla, and it is nothing but this muscle, pectoralis major muscle. We will remove it to expose another one underlying muscle here, pectoralis minor muscle. We also call the pectoralis minor the key to the axilla. Why? If you remove it, you would expose the axilla. Those are nerves of the brachial plexus, the axillary artery. Everything here has been exposed. No wonder we call it the key to the axilla. So those muscles, the pectoralis major, minor, plus this muscle here, remnants of, this is the clavicle, remnants of the subclavius muscle, are the anterior wall. So where is the posterior wall of the axilla? The posterior wall, now I have to extend or abduct, sorry, the arm. And here you go. This is the posterior wall. The posterior wall is made of this muscle. This muscle is the subscapularis muscle. Subscapularis muscle. Plus, this beautifully coming to its insertion. This is latissimus dorsi muscle. Latissimus dorsi. Okay. And here, also another muscle. This one here. I will demonstrate to you this teres major. Now, if we go from above down, subscapularis, latissimus dorsi, teres major, I can tell you that the latissimus dorsi is coming above the teres major, although now you're seeing them the other way around. But remember that this muscle wraps to go to the floor. And the real inferior border of the axilla is the teres major muscle. So it needs further dissection to understand what I'm talking about. So posteriorly, this muscle, subscapularis muscle, latissimus dorsi, and eventually teres major muscle. Three muscles anteriorly, three muscles posteriorly. Okay, what is the medial wall of the axilla? As you can see, these are the ribs. So, what is this muscle here attached to the ribs? Is nothing but the serratus anterior muscle. So, medially, this is medially. This is medially. This is the, those are the fibers of this muscle, the serratus anterior muscle. So, medially, serratus anterior muscle. What's this? This is the long thoracic nerve running on serratus anterior. So, intercostal spaces plus serratus anterior on them is nothing but the medial wall of the axilla. So, hopefully, you would understand this is medial, posterior, anterior has been removed, and eventually, let's talk about the lateral wall. When we put the arm here, this is the lateral wall. It is this part, the bicipital groove, here. Within the bicipital groove is the long head of biceps, and this muscle here, coraco, this is the coracoid process, coraco brachialis. So this muscle is lateral plus the bicipital groove. So those are the walls of the axilla. Now, as I told you, the axilla is pyramidal in shape. This is the axilla. This is the medial wall of the axilla, and this is the lateral wall. The anterior has been removed. So, as I told you, the axilla is a passage between the root of the neck. Here is the root of the neck and the arm. So, those are the nerves coming. This is the brachial plexus, coming from the neck towards the arm. And the axilla is pyramidal in shape. It has an apex. This is its apex, and it is nothing but cervico-axillary canal. This is the first rib running horizontally in your body. It has been cut. The lateral border of this first rib plus the clavicle and the upper border of the scapula, this is, they form the cervico-axillary canal, okay, clavicle, first rib, the outer border of the first rib, medially, anteriorly, the clavicle, scapula, posteriorly. So this is the way we transfer structures from the neck, and between brackets, this is the brachial plexus, accompanied by this subclavian artery becoming the axillary artery here. So the cervico-axillary canal has been exposed to you. As I told you, this is the brachial plexus, and it has to travel to the arm through this area. What is this area? This is the axilla, and this is the anterior wall, pectoralis major, pectoralis minor. This is the axilla. This is serratus anterior, and its nerve running here down, okay, there. So this is the medial wall of the axilla, and this here is the lateral wall. Posterior wall is deep, and you can see how the structures coming from the cervico-axillary canal founding themselves where in the axilla. So I hope this view gives you a better understanding to the axilla in a real cadaver. Now I'll try just to expose to you the axilla for better understanding. This area here is the posterior triangle of the neck. The sternocleidomastoid muscle has been removed, and this is the first rib, clavicle, scapula. This is the cervico-axillary canal, but also has been cut just to expose and to demonstrate to you the underlying structures, the brachial plexus, the axillary artery in this area, subclavian in this area here, and this the axillary artery. So this is the axilla. Look how amazingly all structures from the root of the neck traveled and sheltered themselves in the axilla. This is the medial wall. Here is the lateral wall, and posteriorly is the posterior wall of the axilla. Your last chance to understand the axilla. Here, I've taken a specimen out of the body. It may look to you complicated, but step by step, I'll just demonstrate to you the axilla once again. This is the pectoralis major, the anterior wall of the axilla. When we remove it, you would see pectoralis minor muscle. So the axilla has been exposed. Those are the structures within the axilla. Here is the medial wall. This is serratus anterior. And here is the, of course, the posterior wall subscapularis. This is latissimus dorsi, anterior major should be exposed from a different view. And of course, this muscle here is coracobrachialis. It is on the lateral side plus the structures in the bicipital groove. Medial wall, lateral wall, posterior, and here you go, anterior wall. Very simple demonstration of the axilla. Let me demonstrate to you muscles in the scapular region. This is to orient you the spine of the scapula. This is the acromion, and this, of course, part of the trapezius. Let's not focus on it. Here it is the supraspinous fossa. We have a muscle here. This muscle is the supraspinatus muscle. Supraspinatus muscle. And interestingly, here it's nerve, the suprascapular nerve coming through suprascapular notch. And this nerve goes down to supply this muscle. Triangular in shape, this muscle is the infraspinatus. Look how the nerve sneaks from this notch here. This is the suprascapular nerve supplying the supraspinatus and infraspinatus muscles. Immediately under this muscle is this muscle, teres minor, and eventually this muscle has been also cut. This is teres major, teres major muscle. Here we have this muscle, the subscapularis muscle, and most interesting one here is this muscle. You may not understand how this muscle reached this area, but you have to understand this is serratus anterior and this is the medial border of the scapula. So this muscle was taking its origin from the ribs anteriorly, coming back to the medial end or medial border of the scapula. Hello?